Hello everybody, this is Michelle Fox and welcome back to Quick Tip Friday. Today the burning question is, are you busting your stash or building your stash? Now I'm in the point in my quilting life that I am actually doing both. I do try to use my stash as much as I possibly can, and most of my projects are geared towards that now. However, there are some areas of my stash that I do need to build a little bit. I know that sounds a little ironic, but stick with me and let's dive into this a little bit more. Okay, so what I mean by building my stash is there are things in my stash that are missing. For example, when I make a quilt, a lot of the times I'm missing a specific color. So if I'm trying to use my stash and say I need a yellow and I don't have a yellow, then that's something I'm going to need to purchase if I want yellow in my quilt and can't figure out anything else to use for my quilt. And sometimes, you know, you just have to have a certain color. That's one of the issues with quilting. You just never seem to have the exact fabric that you need. So I'm going to share with you my number one tip for building your stash. That is to know what you have and to only purchase what you absolutely need. Now let me show you what I mean by that. Okay, so let's take a little closer look at my stash. And the majority of my stash is right here. Now I do have some, pre-cuts and fabrics that are part of collections that are elsewhere. And you've seen that in other videos. But this is what I try to do. Okay, so my fabrics, I try to keep them organized by color. And like these right here are all of my 1930 reproduction fabrics and right down here. But you can see these are all of my whites. But down here, I just have a few blacks. And I do use quite a bit of black actually in my quilt projects. So that's my number one tip. Look to see what's in your stash. Know what's in your stash. And know what you need to purchase. So if you find a fabric on sale and it falls in the color scheme that you need, maybe then it's worthy of being purchased. But there are a couple of colors that I'm always short on, and that is black. So I try to look for fabrics on sale that are black, and when I go to a quilt shop, I always look at the blacks. Another one that I don't have a lot of are purples. I just have, I think there's four different purples there. And I do have a few pinks. I built that up just a little bit. Now, I'm not saying you need to buy just tons and tons of these colors, but to have a few colors on hand. Another color that I always fall short on is orange. So those are three colors that I always seem to be needing. Now, what I do to help me remember is I simply take my phone, and once I look through my stash and realize I have a shortage, I mean a real shortage, like just one or two fabrics, pieces of that color scheme, then I just go to my phone and I say, "Hey Siri, put yellow fabric on my fabric list." And it simply puts it on there for me. I don't have to carry around a list in my pocket or in my purse. It's simply in my phone. And nowadays, phones go with everybody, so it's always right there, and I know what I need. Now, I'm not saying that those are the only colors I ever buy, because I have an issue with buying fabric just like most of you. Now, I do have to say some of my subscribers have said that they only buy what they need, and kudos to you, because I think that's great. But for those of us that are building our stash and busting our stash, this is my number one tip. Look to see what you really need. Make a good list. Put it in your phone so that when you go to a quilt shop, you can focus on the fabrics that you really need so that you really can use your stash when you need it. And this works especially well for people who are in rural areas who don't have access to local quilt shops. So if you have a favorite, if you have a tip for building your stash, then put it down in the comments below. So I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you have, hit the like button. Subscribe if you haven't. Please share with a friend. And as always, leave a comment. I love to get the comment and try to reply to each and every one. So until next time, have fun quilting.